In this video, we're going to look at flat packing all our parts and getting it ready for to be sent off for laser cutting. So what I've done just quickly ahead of time is produce this basic Excel spreadsheet which has all the parts that we created and named, and we've also got our quantities for how many of them we need. So with that in mind, let's create a new drawing. So file, new, and we want to select drawing. Now here we want to, instead of selecting a standard size, let's select the size of the sheet that has been provided in the Design Studio document, which is downloadable from Canvas. And this is basically our maximum cutting envelope, which is 300 millimeters by 450 millimeters. So we'll click custom sheet and type that in and then go okay. Now it wants us to select an existing assembly or part to draw on, but we'll just click the X for now. And sometimes your SOLIDWORKS might load a bit funny, so you can just click sheet one and go edit and then just exit. So what we're going to do is go over to the drawing tab and select model view, and we'll click the browse button, and we want to go into the folder where our parts are saved, and we can see that SOLIDWORKS has saved all our parts we made in the assembly as individual parts. So for now we'll click link one. And now it's trying to, it wants us to pick where to put it, so we'll just go up near the corner. And it will want us to select some different views, like an isometric or side or top or bottom view, but we'll just press escape. And this part looks kind of big, so we need to be really careful of this. So if you click the yellow or orange box, this menu pops up on the left showing us some options for this drawing, and we can see under scale it's using the sheet scale. So we want to change that. We want to use a custom scale, and we want to put 1:1 and press enter. And now we can see our part is much smaller. So we can drag and place this anywhere we like, up in the corner. And we want to, we can see where we've got our pins. We have these center lines that SOLIDWORKS has automatically drawn in. We want to remove those because we don't want our laser cutter cutting them. We only want the lines where our laser cutter will cut. So just click and press delete. And now we can click our yellow box and press Control C to copy, and then Control V to paste. And now we can just position these parts. And we know from the Excel spreadsheet we prepared earlier that we need 4 of these. Link one. And then we can go back into our model view, browse, and we'll find link number 2, open, and place that in, press escape. And of course this looks really large as well, so let's change the scale to 1:1. We want to remove our center lines and position the part. Control C, Control V, and place all our parts in. And we'll repeat that for the rest of the parts. I'll go ahead and do that, and I'll be back in 1 second. Okay, so as you can see, I've arranged all my parts on the sheet, and just a few quick things. Sometimes these parts will come in, well, the parts will come into the drawing in the orientation that they are on your model. So you might want to rotate them. So you just click the part and then click the rotate view, and you can rotate it. And as you rotate, it'll snap to 90 or 45 or 0, whatever you want. And just be sure to leave a bit of a gap between the parts. You could probably move these. This looks a bit thin, so I might go back and make them, just drag it and make it a bit of a bigger gap. So now we can just go ahead and save this file, and it's going to save all the references. Confirm drawing view update, we want to press yes, and we're in our folder, and we'll just call this drawing. Now, what's really cool is that these drawings are linked to your actual parts. So if I now go back to my truss bridge, and remember in the previous video we had a look at the equations, so let's edit these. And if we change our tension members to 7 millimeters, and we'll change our compression to twice that, let's say, press OK. All our members have updated. We can go ahead and save this. And now when we go over to our drawing, everything has updated. It might be hard to notice, but you can already see that some of my parts are overlapping now. So they have updated, and now I'll need to just go around and move these out of the way, rearranging, move these around a bit. So now I'm happy with that, or whatever, we can just leave it for now. We want to save this in a appropriate file format for laser cutting. So we'll go to file and just save this, confirm, and we'll go to file, save as. Now save as type, we want to change this to DXF. So we'll click that, call it drawing DXF, and press save. That's okay. So you might get this warning about your drawing views being scaled differently to the sheet. Should be okay, but just always double check your parts and make sure that they are at the correct scale. And that will have generated a DXF, which we can open in certain software. So next I will show you how to arrange your parts in a similar sort of way, but for 3D printing. So this DXF format is only for sheet metal or polymer laser cutting. So I'll see you again in just a second. Okay, so now we're going to rearrange or arrange our parts for 3D printing and set up the correct file format. So we'll just go to File, New Assembly. And we need to select a part, but we'll just press cancel for now. And so we have to make sure all our parts fit in our build envelope. And for 3D printing, that's defined for you in the Design Studio workbook. So let's draw some lines to help us arrange our parts. So we'll go to sketch and we'll sketch on the top plane. And we'll use the center rectangle. And we'll give this our dimensions of our build envelope, which is 300 by 450. And we'll click this shape and then go to for construction and exit that. So now we have our 3D printing build envelope. So now we want to put in our part. So we'll go to assembly, insert, browse, and we'll start with link one. And we can just pop this anywhere into our shape. And whenever you, so the first component that you import into a SolidWorks assembly, SolidWorks will automatically make it fixed, which is this little F symbol. So if we just right click and go to float, we can remove that. So now we want to mate our flat surface here to our top plane. And sometimes the parts shoot off somewhere, so you gotta go looking for them. And we'll just put our view at the top and select move component, and we'll just drag it roughly there in place. And now we want to make multiple of these because we created that build of materials spreadsheet. And so we know we need four of these. And so we'll select a linear component pattern. Here we have components, the pattern. So we'll click that and then we'll, in our tree, we'll select our part. And now we need to define a direction. So either you can use these lines, and you'll see if I click it, it will show us this gray arrow, or we can click our shape. You can see where the arrow is. And you can change the direction as well. So let's do it like this. And of course we can see now we have this preview and all the parts are overlapping, which we don't want. So we can change the distance here. 50, not enough, maybe 55. Yep, that looks good. And of course we can change here how many we want. So we can put in 5 or 3, but we know from our spreadsheet we need 4 of them, and we'll just click the green tick and it will generate our parts. And now we can also select move component, and when we move them, they move together, which is quite handy. So we'll just put this back in the corner. And I think that should be pretty clear. We can also change the name of our local pattern here, and we'll make this link one. So now it's really easy to identify which component patterns correspond to which parts. So yeah, I think that's pretty easy for you guys to just do the rest of the parts yourself as you need. So I'll leave that for now, and I'll just show you how to create the STL file you need for 3D printing. So once all your parts are laid out, you go up to File and Save As. Yep, we want to rebuild, and we'll just call this 3D print and we'll save it. Now we'll go back into here and go Save As again. And this time, instead of type SolidWorks assembly, we're going to select STL, and we're going to get this options box here. So if we click that, we can see that we can set the resolution and accuracy of our round features and such of our parts. So we can move these down and it will be really low quality. So let's just leave these sort of near the end to get high quality. But as we increase this to the maximum, our file size is going to be really large. So we don't want to do that. So about here is good. So we'll press OK and then we'll just go save. And now SOLIDWORKS will generate our STL file. So that's it. Hope you guys have learned something and you're now able to start drawing your bridges in SOLIDWORKS. If you need any extra help, feel free to email any of the tutors or come along to the workshop classes and we can give you a hand. Sheet metal guys, just have a look at the other videos. The steps are pretty similar, but there's some extra sort of different ways of doing that I'll show you, which don't really relate to the acrylic or 3D printing. So check those out. Good luck with your bridge designs, and thanks for watching.